This is Waveshare's 2.66-inch e-ink display module. Unlike usual black and white e-ink or e-paper displays, this is actually red black and white display. It's not that surprising to see red as a third color, considering these displays are nowadays found in, for example, grocery stores as price tags. Red is often used to indicate things like discounted prices. This is actually my first time working with an e-ink display, so I was eager to test this out. Generally, I like how these displays look, and the fact that they don't need to be powered to retain the image is just amazing. I thought this was supported in ESPHome, but there was an extra step I had to do to get this working. And if you were wondering where I got this module, I got this from sponsors PCBWAY.com's module store with my latest order. From the module store you can buy different electronics modules that will be shipped with your usual PCB order. Another great service that our friends at PCBWAY.com are offering. For all your prototyping needs, that is PCBs, 3D prints, CNC milled parts and more, check out PCBWAY.com. E-ink displays are unique because they only use power to update the content on the screen, making it incredibly low power for applications like IoT dashboards and other low power displays. Connecting this specific module to just about any development board is easy thanks to a 8-wire cable that has one plug that connects to the module and individual female connectors for each wire on the other end. Apart from power and ground, I can quite freely choose the pins I want to use on the Wemos D1 Mini, as I can configure the pins on the ESPHome script. Here are the connections I choose to use. You may use different pins if you like. Just make sure to configure the same pins in the ESPHome script. The reset is the module's hardware reset input. It should not be connected to the microcontroller's reset pin, but to a GPIO pin instead. Then microcontroller can use that pin to reset the display during initialization. Then it's time to configure the software side of this thing. I like using ESPHome because it's so easy and quick to work with. Before I got this display, I noticed ESPHome supports Waveshare's e-paper or e-ink displays, and I saw a long list of supported display models and didn't give it another thought. It seemed like just about any possible display size was supported. But I was wrong. This 2.66B wasn't in the list. Luckily, I found a pull request on ESPHome's GitHub, which was someone's effort to add the support for this specific display model. Initially, I thought I need to wait for that pull request to be included in the main ESPHome release, but then I found out about a function called external components. This can be used to import custom components to running ESPHome, overwriting the possibly existing libraries. Source for the custom component can be specific GitHub repo, pull request on the ESPHome's GitHub repo, or local folder. As there is a pull request that adds support for this display, I can specify the pull request number and the components I'd like to use from that pull request. Rest of the components will stay unchanged. I can experiment with custom code while still using the official stable release version of ESPHome. This section will only affect this specific ESPHome project. Apart from the external components section, using this previously unsupported display goes just like with any other Waveshare e-paper display. In the future, when support for this display is included in the official release, all I need to modify in this code is removing the external components section. Before configuring the actual display component, I configured the SPI with clock and MOSI pins, configured a font using font imported from the Google Fonts using its name as a reference, and also configured color for the red pixels. The main display section begins with platform set to Waveshare e-paper, the specific model and rotation according to the physical orientation, and the pinout for the CS, DC, BC and reset pins is assigned here as well. The update interval option is important for these e-ink displays. E-ink displays are not for displaying constantly changing graphics, so don't even think about videos or animations. First of all, the refresh time for this display is about 15 seconds. And to go with the manufacturer's recommendation, Waveshare recommends update interval between 3 minutes and 24 hours. You could select any interval you like, but I've set it to never. This way display updates only when the update action is triggered somewhere in the code. In this case, I have a sensor component that reads value from Home Assistant I have running on my server. This is just a dummy sensor. Doing the same thing with the actual temperature sensor could be done exactly the same way as well. So don't worry about what this dummy sensor is. Inside the sensor's components configuration I have defined onValue automation, which triggers when the sensor value is updated. That triggers component update action, updating the e-ink display. But wait, there's one more thing inside the display section. That is the lambda section. Lambda in ESPHome is for writing some C++ code to handle calculations, conditional actions, and in display's case, drawing stuff on the display. Display component's lambda section is called when ESPHome updates the display. In this demo, I'm printing value from the sensor in red if it is below 0, or in black if it is 0 or above. As I'm triggering the update when sensor's value changes, this will print the current sensor values on the display. Check out ESPHome's documentation for Waveshare ePaper component as well as display component for more specific ways of using this display. Relevant links will be in the description. See you next video. Thanks.